Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Geo Traders. My name is Taren, and this is Blue White Auras for Rivals of Ixalan Standard. So yesterday we streamed Bogles because the past weekend we actually had a Bogles deck take GP Toronto, and I kind of wanted to go over an Auras base deck in Standard, and that is Blue White Auras. But before I get into it, make sure to like the video. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. It really helps us out a lot, really helps the content keep going. But without further ado, let's get right into it. We have Mistcloak Herald. It's a 4 of 1 mana, 1/1 Merfolk Warrior. Mistcloak Herald can't be blocked. Very straightforward, very to the point. A great creature to get through our opponent's wide board state if they have one, or large board state for us. Mistcloak Herald is going to be our one drop always and forever if we get into it into our opening hand. Next up here we have 4 Odonto Vanguard, possibly one of the best white creatures in Standard at the moment. This is a 4 of 2 mana 1/1 Vampire Soldier. As long as Odonto Vanguard is attacking, it gets +2/+0 and you can pay 4 life. Odonto Vanguard gains indestructible until end of turn. Keep in mind we can use Odonto Vanguard's ability on the play or on their turn as well, so it can be used anytime, so it can be used as a blocker or an attacker. So it's great for us to be able to get in as well as keep our creature alive. If it's trying to trade. Next up here, we have 4 Adorned Pouncer, another great card for us. This is a 4 of 2 mana 1/1 cat with double strike. So if it's a double strike 1/1, it hits for 2. But of course, if we hit a 2/2, we do trade with it. It does have eternalize for 5 mana, which means it comes back as a 4/4 double striker, which at that point, it's a huge bomb for us and a huge threat against our opponent. Overall, I love Adorned Pouncer, and I'm glad to see it in a blue white auras list for us. Next up here for us, we have Daring Saboteur. This is an interesting card I picked from us for Ixalan. This is a 3 of 2 mana, 2/1 human pirates. You can pay 3. Daring Saboteur can't be blocked this turn, so it has potentially unblockable. And whenever Daring Saboteur deals combat damage to a player, you may draw a card if you do discard a card. So very good at being able to sift through our deck to grab some cards like more auras we need, or more creatures we need, or maybe even some extra spells we need. Because as you know, getting into mana is one of my strong suits. Daring Saboteur kind of helps us not flood out exactly. And the last 4 creatures in the deck here, we have Sram, Senior Edificer. This is a 4 of 2 mana, 2/2 dwarf advisor, legendary creature. Whenever you cast an aura, equipment, or vehicle spell, draw a card. So this is a blue-white auras list. So there are 18 auras in the entire deck. So that's a lot. That means Sram can actually draw us a lot of cards, potentially, if Sram remains on the battlefield. So, however, Sram can be a removal magnet for us. So we might want to play this out first if we're against red or black first, instead of a Mistcloak Herald or Daring Saboteur. Sram is going to be probably, or most likely, draw that removal to it. But that's all the creatures in the deck. We have 19 in total. Let's go to spells real quick. We have 3 Sheltering Light. Great card for us from Ixalan. It is a 3 of 1 mana instant. Target creature gains indestructible until end of turn, and we get to scry 1. So a great way to have our creature survive over a board wipe, or a kill spell, or just a damage dealing spell like a lightning bolt strike or something like that. Also, we get to scry 1, which is very good on their turn as well. So being able to kind of line up our next play as well. Love Sheltering Light, and that's why it's a 3 of in the deck. Let's move on to auras here. We have 4 Cartouche of Solidarity. It's a 1 mana 4 of enchantment aura cartouche and enchant creature you control. When Cartouche of Solidarity enters the battlefield, create a 1/1 white warrior creature token with vigilance. Enchant creature gets +1/+1 and has first strike. So there was a couple lists where the blue white auras deck kind of turned into a blue white ascend deck, and I liked that list, but I kind of wanted to like simplify it into a deck that's more focused around just the auras. I love this giving +1/+1 and first strike, and getting a 1/1 with vigilance is fine too. Next up here we have 4 Curious Obsession. This is the reason that this deck basically exists now. This is a 4 of 1 mana enchantment aura enchant creature. Enchanted creature gets +1/+1 and has, whenever this creature deals combat damage to a player, you may draw a card. So even better than Daring Saboteur, we don't have to discard a card at all. At the beginning of your end step, if you didn't attack with a creature this turn, sacrifice Curious Obsession. So hopefully we get Curious Obsession onto a Mistcloak Herald and can still attack out turn over turn, getting that card draw advantage. Because if we don't attack, we do lose it, which is not that great for us. Next up here, we have 3 Baffling In. This is a great removal card for us in the main board. This is a 2 mana 3 of enchantment. When Baffling In enters the battlefield, exile target creature and opponent controls with converted mana cost 3 or less. So that's a lot of targets there. And when Baffling In leaves the battlefield, target opponent creates a 3/3 green dinosaur creature token with trample. So it's actually fantastic for us because it actually doesn't give their creature back to them if they destroy Baffling In. It just creates a 3/3 with trample for them, and that might not be what they actually need. This is especially apparent if we grab like a Yahini or something like that. That's a 3 mana 2/2 with haste that actually gets larger and can give itself indestructible. If we Baffling In that, that's amazing. But moving on to more enchantment auras, we have a 4 Cartouche of Knowledge. Great card for us. This is a 2 2 mana, 4 of enchantment aura cartouche, enchant creature you control. When Cartouche of Knowledge enters the battlefield, we draw a card, which is great, and enchanted creature gets +1/+1 and has flying. So opponents have a lot of creatures that are going either going wide or going large. Let's just go flying and go right over them. That's what Cartouche of Knowledge is going to do. And the last three auras in the deck here, we have one with the Wind, another flying enchantment for us. It's a 3 of 2 mana enchantment aura, and enchanted creature gets +2/+2 and has flying. So great for us being able to hopefully like outpace an opponent from a burn spell onto our creature, but it also gives us flying and +2/+2, so very, very good all around. One with the Wind is a fantastic draft card, and it will for sure do some work for us in this actual standard deck here. But that's all the cards in the deck besides the lands here. Let's go over lands real quick. We have two Field of Ruin. Great card for us is being able to get rid of a Legion's Landing that's been flipped, or a Ascanter that's been flipped, things like that. We can add one color strike mana pool or pay two, tap it, sacrifice it, destroy target non-basic land and opponent controls. Each player searches his or her library for a basic land card, put it into the battlefield, then shuffle his or her library. Keep in mind that is untapped and for both of us. Moving on here to other basic lands, we have a Glacial Fortress. This is a buddy land that comes in tapped unless we control a plains or an island. We have the Irrigated Farmlands coming in tapped regardless, or being able to be cycled for to colorless. A great upside for this, if we have this in our opening hand and a Glacial Fortress in the opening hand, Irrigated Farmlands is actually a plains island, so it does mean that Glacial Fortress is coming in untapped. So that's a kind of nice interaction for us for our lands. But moving on from Irrigated Farmlands, we have 4 island and 7 plains. And that is the full 60 on the game 1 game plan. But what can we do against a more aggressive opponent, a more control-heavy opponent, and a more removal-heavy opponent? Let's go to the sideboard real quick. We have, first up, Dive Down, a fantastic card for us. It's a 3 of 1 blue mana instant. Target creature you control gets +0/+3 and has hexproof until end of turn. This is giving our creature temporary bogles and the ability to be able to block something and not die thanks to the +0/+3. Great card for us at being able to block or be able to hopefully get around removal. Next up here, we have Fragmentize. This is a good removal card for us. This is a 1 white mana, 2 of sorcery, destroy target artifact or enchantment with converted mana cost 4 or less. This is going to hit a Heart of Kieran, Scrap Heap Scrounger. This is also going to hit a Cast Out or Ixalan's Binding that's going to hit our side of the field that we do not like, and that's why Fragmentize is in the sideboard. Next up here, we have 2 Spell Pierce. Because we're very fast on the play, Spell Pierce is here to hopefully get rid of a low curve removal spell like a Fatal Push or a Lightning Strike on turn 1 or 2. Spell Pierce is here as a 2 of 1 blue mana instant, counter target non creature spell unless its controller pays colorless. So if we're on the play and they play an Ascanta on turn 2, we can hopefully get rid of it with a Spell Pierce, or if we're on the play and attacking in with at least 1 mana available and they go with a Unlicensed Integration, or if they go with a Fatal Push, we can hopefully get rid of it with a Spell Pierce as well. For more straightforward removal, we have Negate, 3 of here. It's a 2 mana instant counter target non-creature spell. Very straightforward, very to the point, and very powerful against dealing with any kind of planeswalker, any kind of like a secondary approach to the Second Sun, stuff like that, that we don't like hitting the actual casting battlefield. Next up here, we have 2 Squires Devotion. This is for us if we want to use it on the Dawn to Vanguard. This is a 3 mana 2 of enchantment aura, and enchanted creature gets +1/+1 and has lifelink, which is great for us. And when Squires Devotion enters the battlefield, create a 1/1 white vampire creature token with lifelink. So it does 2 different things for us. So it does give us lifelink on the creature we actually cast it on, and it also gives us a 1/1 with lifelink as well, that we can actually put auras on that as well if we need to. Moving up to more absolute removal, we have 2 Cast Out for us. This is a 4 mana instant with flash. And of course, you guys know, it's the enters the battlefield, exile target non-land permanent and opponent controls until Cast Out leaves the battlefield, and it has cycling for 1 white mana. Never going to use Cast Out for cycling. We're going to use it for straight removal, especially if we're up against a deck like Scarab God, Hazoret, things like that, things that we can't really deal with that well. Cast Out is going to deal with it. And the last card for us in the sideboard is a 1 of Settle the Wreckage. We're an aggressive deck going up against another aggressive deck. Might be a bad idea for us, so Settle the Wreckage is in here just to represent that. A 4 mana 1 of instant, exile all attacking creatures target player controls. That player may search his or her library for that many basic land cards, put those cards onto the battlefield tapped, then shuffle his or her library. Giving our opponent mana is kind of bad, but removing our opponent's creatures from play, if they're going to win the game that turn, is very good for us, so that is why Settle the Wreckage is in the sideboard here. So let's go to the full layout here. On MTGO Traders, it's coming to about 32 tickets, which isn't too bad, and on paper, it's coming to about $57. The expensive pieces to the deck are, of course, Adorn Pouncer, Irrigated Farmland, and Glacial Fortress. Everything else is basically under like $2 or like a couple cents in the actual card pool here. This is a real budget deck. So game 1 game plan, turn 1, get out Mistcloak Herald, turn 2, go for Curious Obsession, get out an attack, draw some cards, make sure we continue to keep Mistcloak Herald alive as long as possible, or go for a Danto Vanguard, then a Dorn Pouncer, get some our auras on that, maybe get out a Ceram, draw some cards by placing auras on other creatures we control, use Sheltering Light to protect our creatures, make sure to utilize Baffling In to get some creatures out of the way so we can actually finish the game off, and use Cartouche of Knowledge and One with the Wind to get over the creatures our opponent controls and close out the game. But that is it for the decklist, guys. Let me know what you think. Do you like it? Do you hate it? Do you have any suggestions for it in the comments below? Please let me know. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you haven't already. We have more content like this always coming out. I really appreciate you guys sticking around. We are so close to 10,000. So close. It's awesome. We actually hit like 1 million views over the weekend, which is great. So I appreciate you guys so much. And I'll see you guys on the stream or in the next Deck Tech. Peace.